So I was recently asked by somebody if I knew what the tiny text on the back of the iPhone meant. So I thought I'd take a look. And boy, is it tiny. And you can find some text on the back of the iPhone and on the back of the iPad. And it seems to be different and depends which model you have. So here I am just looking at the 7 Plus. And on the back of the 7 Plus, under the large text of iPhone, I can see it says, designed by Apple in California, assembled in China. So that's true. Designed by Apple in California is something that Apple's had on products for years, decades, I think. It's kind of a symbol of pride that they're a California company. And assembled in China, of course, is true. The iPhones are assembled in China, although I guess some are now assembled in Brazil. And we might see some other countries soon as well. So it'll be interesting to see how that's reflected there. Now under that, you've got the model number. So the 7 Plus, it's model A1784. And that's there on the back. Then you see an Fcc ID. Now as you can imagine, this is the identification number provided by the FCC. Apple submits the iPhone for testing by the FCC to make sure it complies with all rules and laws and things like that. And then the FCC has to approve it. I found out that BCG part, that's Apple's identifier. So anything with an FCC ID BCG is an Apple product. And then the number after it is something that Apple supplies. So they actually say this is device E3092A. They tell the FCC that. When the FCC approves it, they can then put this little FCC ID on the back. I see the C stands for Canada. And this is the Canadian version of the FCC and following all those rules. And you can see a similar number there. And I imagine that it's different if you bought an iPhone somewhere else, since the iPhone I got, I guess, was approved for sale in the United States and Canada, then it has these symbols on it. Now you can look up this FCC number on the FCC.gov site and you can get some interesting things about your iPhone. So I did a Google search on the FCC ID and it got me to the FCC.gov site. There's probably a way to search inside FCC.gov. And there they make public all of the documents that Apple provided to the FCC for testing. This includes lots of photos, different letters, different things, even the PDF manual that you can get from Apple. They include that as well. There's some interesting things though, like for instance internal photos. So you can actually look at the internal photos that Apple provided to the FCC and see what the inside of your iPhone looks like. And here you go. And you could see some pretty interesting stuff if you're ever curious what it looks like inside your device but don't want to crack it open to find out. So here's the back of my iPad. And it's a little different. They're still designed by Apple in California, assembled in China. Then it's got the model number over here. And then it has the FCC and IC identification there. And notice that for this iPad they actually use that same A1673. This is an iPad Pro 9.7 inch from last year. They use that model number in the FCC filing. There's also the serial number for my specific iPad isn't printed on the back. Interesting that it's not on the iPhone. Then you've got these special symbols here at the bottom. The FCC one is showing that as FCC approval. The trash can with the X through it shows that it complies with certain waste disposal rules. And the rest of the symbols have to do with the European Union. That CE is the official it's okay to sell it in the European Union symbol. And the exclamation point with a circle around it right there in the middle, that has to do with looks like similar rules for FCC but for the European Union. I'm not quite sure what the number is there, but I'm thinking since it's between two European Union symbols, it may be something to do with that. A search for the FCC ID for my iPad turned out a similar set of documents including internal photos so you can go and see what the inside of an iPad looks like as well. And finally, here's what I found on the back of my 2016 MacBook Pro. And you can see some of the same things on it. In addition, there's another Canadian number there, that's C-A-N-I-C-E-S. And that's another number for compliance in Canada. And then there's some symbols at the bottom. The one that looks like the box with the VCCI in it, that's for Japan. And the triangle with the circle and the check mark, that's for Australia.